Hi and welcome back. We're still talking about optimization. So what we were actually talking about before was that to do optimization, one has to profile things. One has to measure things in order to be sure that what one's doing is making sense. So I'm going to give you a demo of a profiler. The profiler I'm going to use is called JVisualVM. So I start it up, and this is what it looks like. You've got your applications here, and there's nothing really going on. So let's go and start up a Java program. So I'm going to start up this program called Weka. And I just started it, and you can see it shows up here. So I'm going to click Explorer, because I know I use Weka, and it's still there. So I can double click on this, and you can see that it tells me the PID, the host, what VM I'm using, threads, things like that. I can monitor things, so it's allowed to use this kind of heap size, but it can only use that much. This is how many threads it's got. This is number of loaded classes, 4,000. This is the CPU usage. Okay, so that is this program. So now watch as I say open a file, and I'll open up this MaxDB data file. And you can see more memory is being allocated, more CPU is being used, threads, slight number of more classes created. So I can get a general idea of what's going on. Right? So that's sort of interesting. I can go and take a look at the threads. We can see that there's destroy Java VM thread, AWT thread, Java 2D disposer, things like that. And I can also check out the sampler. We'll check out the profiler. So the profiler will count things for us. So let's tell it to profile the CPU. So it just said instrumentation. Instrumentation means that it's modifying that Java VM such that it can be measured. Okay, so now that's set to go. Let's get back into Weka. And we can see that in Weka more things are being run. So I'll just move this into the middle here. We'll go back to Weka. Alright, so I'm going to tell it to use 0R and to classify things. So Weka is now working away. It's training a 0R model. It took that long to run, and it continues to run. It's telling me the time that each thing took to run, and it's telling me this process classifier prediction is running, and these get to strings, and they ran that many times. What took the most time was this TCP handler, this image fetcher. We can order by invocations. We can see that class index and num attributes are called a lot, values called a lot. If we go back to Weka, we can see that it produced something. This is sort of interesting. So we can choose a different learner in Weka. We can say choose Weka's not quite working. I'm going to restart Weka. Explorer. Alright, let's open a file again. So it's saying the thread pool's working. We're loading stuff up, loading files. We can see what methods run. We can see the percent of self time. Who's responsible for the most stuff right now? Right now it says the thread pool workers running cost the most. So this means that Weka running multiple threads is costing a lot. by invocation, we can see that instance value, num instance that, this stuff is all being called very quickly. We're reading from a file. The problem with the profiler is that it will get in the way of all calls, or most of the calls. So stuff gets really slow, right? So we're still waiting on Weka to load that. So we can see these numbers going up here. So instance is calling a lot, element at, value is missing, those kinds of things keep getting called. So it's having a hard time reading this method. So it's interesting nonetheless. I'm going to tell it to stop profiling because it's going to take forever. And I'm going to close Weka. We're going to close this. And I'm going to close Weka. I'm going to restart Weka. So I'm restarting Weka. Go into Explorer. Now we go back to the Java thing. We can see that we have to double click. Starts up a new one. Let's go to the sampler. I'm going to go CPU. So the sampler does is handy because it does it samples. It doesn't run everything. So see, I can go load up MaxDB. It's telling us we've got the show dialog. Now we're getting this to string. We got these visualized things. That's what's taking time. So it's sampling. It's telling us what percentage of the time it saw was being spent on these things. And you can see this instant int took up a tenth of a second in internal fields, things like that. It's pretty interesting. All right, so then let's do the classification again. 0R. So you can see it ran way faster. It's much faster because it doesn't have to do the work of the profiler. And we can see that things like the ARF reader, the thing that read the file, we can see the instances are important. So now let's choose something else. Let's go to, let's choose a Bayesian function, naive Bayes. Let's run that. So it makes this naive Bayes function. It's running this this machine learner model multiple times. The sampling's still happening. We can see update classifier is being called a lot. So the naive Bayes classifier is taking time. If we look at the overview, the monitor, we can see we took CPU time to do that. We took memory to do that. Back to the sampler. Check out the threads. You can see that that thread was running. All right, normal probability. That's what was taking the time, was calculating normal probability. So if we could calculate normal probability faster, maybe it would work. Also, sorting took a lot of time. Partitioning instances took time too. So another thing we can do is we can say, well, let's use Bayesian logistic regression. And we can see normal probability still matters. Our build classifier is very expensive. It's taking a lot of time. It's giving us a hint. Normal probability is still pretty high, partition pretty high. So we get to see that this build classifier is very expensive. It's taken 26 seconds. And it's working away. So it's got all these features. It's working away. Alright, so it's done. 36 seconds for that. We got to see that. We can do other things. We can actually look at memory. So let's go to memory. So we see doubles take up a lot, chars take up a lot, ints take up a lot. Well, let's go to preprocess. Let's open a new file. Let's go MaxDB again. And we can see now doubles are taking up quite a bit of space. Double arrays are pretty big. Int chars, this stuff's all pretty big. All right? So then let's go to classify again, and let's try this Bayesian logistic regression, and let's see what takes up memory now. So we're seeing it build models, and now we see this stuff is ballooning up. The attributes are pretty big. So Weka's mostly Mostly about double arrays. Mostly about double arrays. Not much really interesting stuff happening here. But this is normal. These primitives tend to be pretty big. It's almost done. There. So, that's the result. Now strings are pretty big. So what if we go to, say, something like cluster, and we tell this thing to start clustering? It's making lots and lots of instances. It's using lots of bytes. It's making double arrays and getting rid of double arrays. If we go by number of instances, we can still see, like, the strings are the most common, followed by chars and booleans. Still training. In terms of bytes, doubles are still big, but instances, there's a lot. There's a lot of characters. So you get this idea of what's actually running. What's important, though, is one should consider, if one wants to improve the performance of something, one should measure this performance beforehand, then measure it after. All right? So I hope this gave you a good intro into the Weka, or into the Java profiler. Gives you some idea of how to get information about what's running. See how you can use CPU or memory. And you can see the memory here. Lots of allocations, deallocations, lots of CPU use. So it should be noted that this computer is pretty fast, and 6.8% is probably one core being used, because it's running one thread, right? So this thread stuff's pretty neat, because you can also see how things changed over time. All right, so I hope you guys learned something from this. Thanks.